The 2019 MLS Cup playoffs kick off right here in Toronto as your Reds take on DC United this coming Saturday. Marie Papadakis here getting you all set up for round one with Painting the Picture presented by Benjamin Moore. It's a return to the playoffs for Toronto FC since their 2017 MLS Cup win, and their quest for another title begins this weekend. This year's playoff format features a new twist as Major League Soccer has introduced single game elimination matches, taking place of the home and away series format. Now it's win or go home all the way through to MLS Cup, meaning the intensity will be ratcheted up all the way starting from the opening whistle. Saturday marks the third meeting for Toronto and DC in 2019. During the regular season, the two sides met twice, with both contests ending in a draw, including a 0-0 result at BMO Field on May 15th and a 1-1 stalemate at Audi Field on June 29th. The Capital Club employed a very defensive style of play against the Reds in previous meetings, looking for opportunities to strike on the counter. This was especially apparent in the May 15th match at home as your Reds outshot their opponents 36-3. However, DC watched out their top attackers Wayne Rooney, Luciano Acosta, and Paul Arriola from the start of the match. It'll be up to the Reds this weekend to come out firing on all opportunities to score early and take the lead. Now, for more in-depth analysis on the match, let's over to Gareth Wheeler and Terry Dunfield.
Thanks so much, Maria. So, Terry, this DC United team, obviously very defensive. The second best defensive or goals against record in all of Major League Soccer over the course of the regular season. What makes them so good defensively, and how does Toronto FC go about breaking them down?
Yeah, there's experience. It's Ben Olsen's ideology. It's very well organized. Every player on that pitch knows what their role is. It's two banks of four with two ahead of them, probably Rooney and Acosta given a little bit of freedom. But to break those two banks of four down, it's going to be difficult. There's not a whole bunch of space in between them. It's quite narrow at times. But I think TFC unlocked them a little bit in their previous meetings by Michael Bradley hitting that outside to in diagonal, almost from side to side, creating a time edge in a wide area. Another way would be isolating wingers or fullbacks in 1v1 situations where they skip past their mark and now there's an overload that way. Or the other way is just getting to that byline and looking for that cut back to the penalty spot in between lines.
When you look at his TFC team, Jozy Altidor obviously is going to be a game time decision. So if Altidor can't go from the start, what kind of look do you expect from Toronto FC, and how do they make up for his absence?
Yeah, it's an interesting one. I'd guess probably Pozuelo plays a little bit as a false nine, which might be okay, because in Birnbaum and Brilliant, the two center halves of DC actually match up nicely to a big man. I think Pozuelo's movement in between lines could cause problems. The other way is you could have Mullins up top who might look for those little darty runs in behind.
But how much will they suffer or pay for not having Altidor? I mean, if they're going to sit back, do you need an Altidor leading the line, or can you find your attack elsewhere?
Yeah, good question. I think it's a nice fit probably for Pozuelo. It also brings Benazee in the team, where Endo can stay in the team as well. Another way TFC could break them down too is in attacking transition, where they break from their defensive shape when DC aren't organized.
DC United has one famous player. He was their leading goal scorer of the season. His name's Wayne Rooney. Ever heard of him? This could be his last game here in Major League Soccer. He has 11 goals on the season, but hasn't scored since July, Terry. And only 5 of those 11 goals have come from open play. He's going to be a focal point. How do you defend such a great player like Wayne Rooney?
Yes, his career's kind of evolved, and he still has that same quality where he can turn a game in a second, but he won't control a game like he used to. He'll pick his moments where if he's got a little bit of time and space, he might see that reverse pass, or he might hurt you on a set piece. So I don't think you can put too much focus into him, but when he does get it, pick up runners and don't give them a lot of time and space.
I know penalties are always a worry for Toronto FC fans. A reminder, DC United fell in the first round of last year's MLS Cup playoffs in penalties at home to Columbus Crew. So it's hardly a team that you need to be scared of in terms of that perspective. And if you like the stars lining up, Alan Chapman's a referee for this weekend's match. He officiated that DC United Crew playoff game from a season ago. Back to you, Maria.
Thanks so much, guys. Kickoff is around the corner, and you can tune in to watch the match at 6 p.m. on TSN, or visit torontofc.ca/playoffs for remaining tickets and all your game day information. Make sure to join me for the March the Match happening at Brazenhead. Then we'll be heading over to the pre-match party happening in the North End patio prior to kickoff. Thanks so much for watching, everyone, and I'll see you Saturday.